Urology is known as surgical specialty, but although we do great variety of open, endoscopic, laparoscopic, and robotic-assisted surgeries, urology is not only surgery. There may be no other specialty which has such a combination of surgery and medicine and advances in technology as urology. We urologists often not only diagnose and treat our patients, but we also follow them up. Indeed, this patient interaction is a key part of urology. It is very important, and it is very rewarding as well. Many people think that urology is something that deals with male genitals, especially prostate. But actually, we treat many other problems as well. We treat a variety of urinary symptoms, bladder and kidney cancer, kidney stones, neurological problems of urinary tract, urinary infection, urinary incontinence, pelvic pain, and sexual and reproductive health problems. And not only in men, but also in women and children. One of the rewarding things in urology is that many of our treatments are truly effective. However, there's definitely room for improvement. Principles of evidence-based medicine are great tools when trying to improve patient care in urology. The first principle of evidence-based medicine is that we need systematic summaries of the best available evidence. This is because when clinical decisions are based only on expert recommendation, they often misguide. The second principle of evidence-based medicine is that hierarchies of evidence tell us what evidence is best. For instance, if we want to know if treatment A is better than treatment B, we should conduct randomized trials comparing these treatments. Why bother with randomized trials? Comparative studies that are non-randomized typically suffer from imbalance of prognostic factors leading to biased estimates. In large randomized trials, however, prognostic factors, both known and unknown, are balanced in the treatment and control arms. For instance, the same proportion of older and the same proportion of sicker people will exist in treatment and control arms, leading to fair comparison. The third principle of evidence-based medicine is that evidence alone never tells us what to do. We always need values and preferences, preferably patient values and preferences. The Clinical Urology and Epidemiology CLU Working Group, the research group I lead, works on a range of projects at the forefront of evidence-based medicine, aiming to deliver improvements in our understanding of disease management across urology and other areas of medicine and surgery. On the first principle, we need a systematic summary of best available evidence. We have contributed substantially in urology by conducting numerous important systematic reviews and meta-analyses on urinary symptoms, prostate cancer, and complications of urologic surgery. Maybe the most important of those systematic reviews was a series of systematic reviews on procedure-specific risks of blood clots and major bleeding after different urologic surgery operations. This work led to clinical practice guideline of the European Association of Urology, which was the first ever procedure-specific guideline in any field of surgery. This guideline, published in 2017, globally rationalized prevention of blood clots post-surgery. The second principle of evidence-based medicine is that hierarchies of evidence tell us what evidence is best. When deciding if treatment has efficacy, randomized trials answer most reliably. It is therefore very important that we perform more large-scale randomized trials that focus on areas with great importance to patients and health systems, and use patient-important outcomes and study populations that represents patients we treat. The CLU Working Group is leading two global major large simple trials. The APPEAL trial examines antibiotics as a prevention of infections after kidney stone interventions, and ARDS trial, which examines prevention of blood clots and bleeding in more than 5,000 general gynecologic and urologic surgery patients. ARDS trial will answer crucial management questions and influence future perioperative practices around the world. We are also currently performing the largest COVID trial in Finland, Solidarity Finland, which is part of WHO's mega trial of more than 15,000 patients. This unfortunate COVID pandemic has highlighted the importance of large, simple randomized trials. To be successful in answering important questions in a pandemic, one must do many things correctly. The most important issue is to perform simple and large trials, because only they can provide accurate answers with the needed rapidity. Throughout the world, however, over-regulation and the lack of national and international efforts to facilitate appropriately large trials represents a missed opportunity to improve patient care. Therefore, of the more than 2,000 planned drug studies examining COVID-19 treatments, most studies have delivered little or no useful information. Exceptions include the UK's recovery and the global WHO solidarity trials. They have been successful due to collaboration, which is between health systems, patients, researchers, doctors, hospitals, universities, funders, authorities, and many, many more. The third principle of evidence-based medicine is that evidence alone never tells what to do. We always need values and preferences, preferably patient values and preferences. This is unfortunately often a neglected part of medicine and surgery, both in clinical practice and in research. In future, we must teach researchers, doctors, and the lay public more about the importance of assessment of patients' values and preferences and expectations, about shared decision-making and partnership with patients. In the CLUE working group, our research has contributed to improving decision-making of prostate cancer treatment decisions and decision-making of prostate cancer screening. In future, we will explore many other patient-important questions. With values and preferences research, we aim to improve the position of patients, both in clinical care and in clinical research. Successful research is a team sport. More than anything else, collaboration is the key to success. The goal of our team sport is to create well-being. I'm thankful for this new position, and I hope it helps us to achieve our goals of better evidence-based care in urology and beyond.